Michael Mancos over here. Even if you want to use 32-bit VST instruments in Cubase, they are all filed on a blacklist, because Cubase no longer supports 32-bit plugins. But we've got two options to use 32-bit plugins in Cubase yet. So we need a kind of 32 to 64-bit bridge. The first one is to buy JBridge and hope that plugins work with JBridge. And the other one is very simply for free and works. All we need is the free demo version of FL Studio. The reason why is because FL Studio works fine and without problems with 32-bit plugins on 64-bit systems. And in Cubase, we can use FL Studio as a fully compatible VST instrument. Once FL Studio is installed and the plugins found by the FL Studio plugin manager and filed in the FL Studio browser, then we can close FL Studio and continue on Cubase. In Cubase, we load the whole FL Studio as an VST instrument. Cubase and FL Studio communicates flawless over rewire, and down here in our taskbar, we can switch between Cubase and FL Studio. In the Cubase inspector, we route the FL Studio channel at first. For example, I use the track drums of FL Studio. Now I switch to FL Studio, select the plugin I want to have, and put it on the track drums. Now I switch back to Cubase by just putting FL Studio aside. Back in Cubase, I can use the 32-bit plugin now and work with it. However, yes, there's a small handicap. Because FL Studio is a demo version, we can save our plugin arrangement and project, because it's a combined FL Studio project now. But unfortunately, we can't reload our project in the demo version. That works just in the full version. But changes we make on our synthesizer plugin by creating a new sound or changing parameters, that we can save and reload again. Okay, that looks complicated at all, but it's very easy to use, and so I'll show you how it looks like if you start a new project in Cubase using 32-bit plugins with FL Studio. Hope I could help you a little. Bye bye. Have fun, Michael.